If you're in Nigeria, you cannot buy cryptocurrencies directly from your bank account or using your bank card because in 2021, the CBN prohibited Nigerian banks from facilitating crypto transactions. And since then, the most common way to buy or sell cryptocurrencies in Nigeria is through a P2P system. This is a system where people transact cryptocurrencies among themselves. Instead of using your bank to buy from an exchange, you buy directly from somebody else, you pay the person, and then the person transfers the cryptocurrency to you. But the problem with a P2P system like this is that it is very risky because you are not sure if the person you are paying money to will actually transfer the crypto to you after you've sent the money. Or let's say if you want to sell your cryptocurrency, for instance, you are not sure if the person will actually send you the money after you've transferred your cryptocurrency to them. That is why in this video, I'm going to show you how to securely buy or sell your cryptocurrencies on Binance P2P. And before we jump into it, if you enjoyed this video, please hit the like button. And if you are new to the channel, you're welcome. My name is Emmanuel, and on this channel, I create videos that will help you make money online. And if you want to see more of this kind of videos, make sure to smash the subscribe button and also turn on all notifications so that you'll be the first to know whenever I upload a new video. And with all that said, guys, let's jump into my phone screen where I'll show you how to buy and sell cryptocurrencies on Binance P2P. So to get started, just open your Binance account. If you don't have a Binance account yet, I've already made a video that will show you how to do that. I'll link the video in the description below. But basically, log into your Binance account. If it's a new Binance account, before you start trading, you want to make sure that your account is verified. Also, you should have added the payment method you want to use to your Binance account. So if I come back to P2P payment method, here you can add the bank account you are going to use when buying and selling on Binance P2P. So you can easily do that by clicking on add the payment method and then select bank transfer and just follow the prompt. Also, you want to make sure that you have two-factor authentication enabled on your account. Once you have all of that in place, let's go back to our homepage. And what you want to do is to click on P2P. This is what the P2P interface looks like. Under the buy section, you are going to see buying ads. And if you want to buy cryptocurrency, this is the tab you are going to use. So here are people who have placed ads to sell their cryptocurrencies. And if you want to buy, you can just go ahead, click on buy. And then the second tab is the sell tab. And these are people who have placed ads to buy cryptocurrencies from you. So if you want to sell your crypto, this is the tab you are going to use. Another way to go about this is to place your own ads on Binance. Let's say if you want to buy, you can come over to the sell section and place your buying ads. Or if you want to sell, you can come over to the buy section and place ads to sell your crypto. In this video, I'm going to show you both how to buy and sell on P2P. Then in a future video, I'm going to show you how to place your own buying and selling ads on Binance. Now, let's say I want to buy a particular cryptocurrency. You want to come over to the buy section. The first thing you want to do is to set the currency you want to use, the fiat currency. Mine is set to NGN, which is Nigerian Naira. But if you want to use a different currency to buy, you can select any currency you want to use. Let's say you want to use USD, you can just come back to the search box, search for USD. Or if you want to use British pounds, you can just search for GBP and all of that. But let's say I want to buy with Naira at the moment. And then the next thing you want to do is to select the cryptocurrency you want to buy. And you can see there are just a couple of options available on P2P. If you need a cryptocurrency that is not available on P2P, you can buy any of these ones, maybe USDT, and then convert it to the currency you need. Binance has a convert feature that will help you do that. Now, let's say you want to buy Bitcoin. You can just click on BTC and that'll show you the ads under Bitcoin. Or if you want to buy BUSD, you can click on BUSD or BNB, whichever one. But for this video, let's say I want to buy USDT. So I'm going to click on USDT. And here you are going to see a lot of ads from people who want to sell their crypto. Because there are too many of them, it might take a very long time for you to scroll through and find the one that fits you. And that is why you have these filters at the top to make the whole process easier for you. The first filter is the amount. And here you can just enter the amount you want to buy in Naira. Let's say I want to buy USDT worth 20,000 Naira. If I type in 20,000 Naira here and then click confirm, now I'm going to see only ads within my buying range. And then another filter you can use is the payment method. You can click on payment method and here you can see a lot of options. Usually, you can just click on all because since you've set your currency to Naira, the payment methods that will be available will mostly be bank transfer, which is something you can use. Now, among the results, you want to proceed to look for somebody you can actually do business with. And before you choose somebody to buy from, here are some metrics I like to look at. First is the number of trades this person has completed on the platform. The more trades, the more you can trust the person because obviously that person has been on the platform for a while and they have done a lot of transactions. That means you can trust them more than somebody who has just a few trades. So the first person we have here has over 5,000 trades and has a completion rate of 93%. The second person has over 8,000 trades and have a completion rate of 98%. So the completion rate of this person is better than the first. Generally, anybody that has over 95% completion rate is good for business. You are less likely to have issues with that transaction. The next thing you want to look at is the rate. Now, the first person here has a rate of 758.38 Naira per USDT. The second person has 758.45 per USDT. Now, except you are buying in bulk, these Kobo differences might not mean a lot. So if you are buying just a few USDT, a difference of maybe 2 Kobo, 5 Kobo might not make a lot of difference. But if you are buying a lot, then it's going to be huge. You want to look for the best deal. Another thing you can look at is their transaction limit. That is the minimum and the maximum amount of payment these people are willing to receive. So you basically want to check through and look for somebody that meets your own personal criteria. Right now, I'm going to work with this Worker Exchange. Worker Exchange has done over 2,800 trades and has a completion rate of 99%, which is very high. And the limit is within my buying range because I want to buy just 20,000 Naira worth of cryptocurrency. And this person can accept payment as much as 188,000 Naira. So what I'm going to do right now is to click on buy. On this page, you are going to see some details. But one very important thing you need to look at is the seller's term. For instance, under terms, you are going to see that no third-party payment. If you pay from a different account, you will lose your asset, blah, blah, blah. Also, you are going to see don't write anything crypto related. That's very important because, you know, banks cannot be involved in crypto transactions. So you want to make sure that in the narration of your transaction, you don't type anything crypto. If not, both your account and the person you send the payment to might get blocked. So instead of typing something like USDT or BTC or Bitcoin, you can just type in your name. So if you read through these terms and you don't have any problem with it, you can come over here and enter the amount you want to buy. Let's say I want to buy USDT of 20,000 Naira. Here you see the amount of USDT that I'll get, which is 26.37 USDT, and I'm going to pay 20,000 Naira. You can also use buy crypto. Here you are going to enter the amount of crypto you want to buy. So if I enter 26 USDT, that means I'm going to pay 19.721. It's just better that I use by fiat. So I'll just enter the amount and then click on buy with zero fee. Now, this is where you are going to get a summary of the payment. The amount of USDT I'm buying is 20,000 Naira. The price is 758.50 Naira per USDT. And for this, I'm going to get 26.36 USDT. Now, what you want to do to proceed with this payment, you can just click on make payment. Also, in the process of making your payment, you can chat with the seller. Let's say you want to ask seller questions or whatever, but usually the chat is not even necessary. Once you proceed to make the payment, your order is going to be confirmed. Now, this is the account details I'm going to send the payment to. What I'm going to do right now is to go over to my bank app and transfer the money to this account. It's an OPI account, and here's the bank name and the account name. And if you need a reference message, by all means, like I mentioned, you can just type in your name there, or you can copy this reference message and use in the narration. When making the transfer, you want to make sure that the name matches the name you can see right here on Binance so that you don't send the money to the wrong account. So I'll go over and make this payment right now. I have made a transfer of 20,000 Naira. The next thing I need to do is to click on transferred, notify seller. Now it's left for the seller to check with their bank and confirm that I've actually sent the correct amount. And once they receive the payment, they are going to release the crypto to you. And sometimes during P2P transactions, there might be some issues where maybe the seller or the buyer is delaying the transaction. They don't want to confirm payment or whatever. Or you send the payment and then they are claiming they have not received the payment. First, you can talk to them directly. And if that is not working out, you can create an appeal so that Binance is going to come in and try to resolve the issue. The seller has received my payment and has released my 26 USDT for me. You can rate them if you want, but right now just click on done. Now you can come over and check your Binance funding wallet, and you should be able to see the asset you just bought inside your funding wallet. And this is basically how you can buy crypto on Binance P2P. It's very easy and straight to the point. Next, let me show you how you can sell. Let's say I want to sell maybe 20 USDT right now. I'll come over to P2P again, click on P2P. And then in this case, we'll switch to sell because we are the one selling now. You already know all the basic steps. I'm going to filter by the amount of cryptocurrency I want to sell will be in the range of maybe 15,000 Naira. That's 20 USDT. So I'll confirm. Then I'm going to look for an ad that I can sell to. For this instance, I'll just pick the first ad, over 2,000 trades, 98% completion rate. And the rate is also quite good, 755.42. So I can just go ahead and click on sell. Now I'll enter the amount I want to sell. So I'm going to use 20 USDT. You can also set the amount by fiat. You can come over and enter the amount you want to sell in Naira, but I'm going to use just 20 USDT for now. Then you can select the payment method you want to use. This is where you get to choose the account you want them to send this money to. So I'm going to select this, and here you see the quantity and the amount you are going to receive. I'm going to receive 15,108 Naira. And you can also read their terms. This just says online. That's very simple. I'm going to edit the amount I want to sell. So instead of receiving 15,100 and all of that with Kobo added to it, I'll just enter 15,000 Naira and then just click on sell with zero fee. Now, since I am the one selling in this case, I just need to wait for the buyer to send the payment to my account. Once they have made the transfer, they are going to alert me that the payment has been sent. Then I'll go into my bank app to confirm whether I have received the payment or not. If I receive the payment, I'm going to confirm the payment right here on Binance, and Binance is going to release the cryptocurrency to them. So let's just wait for this person to send the payment of 15,000 Naira to my account. Also, just like when buying, you can actually chat with the person that you are selling your crypto to. So our buyer has indicated that they have sent the payment, and what you want to do now is to make sure you check your bank app and be sure that the money has been sent in the exact amount. So I'll go over to my bank app now, and yes, I have received the payment of 15,000 Naira from this buyer. The next thing I need to do is to click on payment received. Then you want to check I have received the correct amount. So once I check that, I'll click on confirm. I'll need to confirm two-factor authentication. I'm going to use the authenticator app. If you want to use SMS to verify the transaction, under SMS, you can click on send code and the code will be sent to your phone number. Enter the code right here and submit. But I'm going to use authenticator, paste the code and then click submit. And you can see I've successfully sold 19.85 USDT for 15,000 Naira. And this is how you can sell your cryptocurrencies on Binance P2P. Now, you might be asking, how secured is this process? The basic thing is Binance has systems in place to make sure that users and their assets are safe. So when you want to buy cryptocurrency from somebody, for instance, Binance is going to make sure that the seller has sufficient amount of the cryptocurrency in their account. And during the transaction, Binance is going to temporarily hold that amount of cryptocurrency in escrow. Then when you transfer the payment to the person's account and the person confirms your payment, Binance is going to release that exact amount of cryptocurrency to your account. So technically, nobody can run away after you've made payments without releasing the crypto to you. And if they don't want to confirm the payment, that is where you can appeal. Then Binance is going to come in and try to look into what happened and then settle the issue the right way. The same goes for when you are trying to sell. Binance is going to ensure that you have sufficient amount of that crypto in your account. And then when you enter a trade, Binance is going to temporarily hold your asset until the transaction is complete. Once you confirm the payment, Binance will release the asset to the buyer. But you want to make sure that you don't release the crypto until you actually confirm that the money is in your account. Another reason why the P2P market on Binance is very safe is because Binance usually remove accounts that are fraudulent. That's people who try to scam people of their cryptocurrency. Binance is going to restrict the account. and you are less likely to meet those kind of people when trading. But despite all the safety features that Binance has in place, you also want to make sure that you are not careless with the process. You want to make sure that you actually know what you are doing so that you don't lose your money. And that's basically it for this video, guys. I hope the information in this video was helpful to you. If you enjoyed this video, please hit the like button. I really appreciate that. Thanks for watching, guys. I'll see you in the next one.